Hey again. Okay, so we're going to continue talking about dividing with decimals, and I kind of want to relate it to what we do with numbers in fractions versus what we do with numbers in decimals when we have a remainder. So if I was going to solve this problem, like say it was this, right? This was a fraction, an improper fraction. I have to convert it into a mixed number. I just go like this. Okay, so I go 6, can go into 31. I can go 5 times. 30, I have 1 left over. So I have 5 and 1 sixth, right? And so I would come back over here and say 5 and 1 sixth. So when I got my remainder, when I got to this point, I brought it up, right, and wrote it as the top of my fraction. In decimals, in dividing decimals, there's kind of a weird thing that we can do. We can add in a decimal point and a zero and just keep dividing, so that if we end up with a remainder like this, it doesn't, we don't have to write a fraction, or we don't have to say remainder one or whatever. So let me show you how that's done. Let's do the same problem, 6 into 31, okay? It can still go 5 times, and I have, that means 30, I have that 1 left over. Here's what I'm going to do. Let me grab a different color here. I am going to drop in a decimal point, okay? Put my decimal point, I'm going to bring it straight up as well, and add a zero, and I'm going to bring that zero down. So now can 6 go into 10? Absolutely. How many times can 6 go into 10? Well, it goes 1 time, right? And I have 4 left over. Oops, that's still a remainder. I'm going to add in another zero and drop it down. Because see, these zeros that I'm adding in up here are those unnecessary zeros. So it's not like they're changing the size of this 31. This is still 31. I just have a bunch of zeros after it now. And as long as in my answer I'm keeping the new numbers that I'm creating after the decimal point, then I should be all good. Okay, so now 6 is going to go into 40. That goes 6 times, which is 36. I have 4 left over, right? I'm going to bring down a 0. I have 40 goes into 6 goes into 40 6 times, which is another 36. I've run out of room here. But do you see what keeps happening? If I kept adding zeros, it would just keep having sixes after it forever. So I could write a line over top of that 6, which this indicates that that 6 is repeating. And I would say that 31 divided by 6 is 5.166 repeating. And that would be my answer. So instead of writing it the fraction way, I am going to write it the decimal way. Let's look at another example, just because this is sort of a weird phenomena. And we just want to practice it, I think, just a little bit. Okay, 4 divided into 27.5. So the first thing I'm going to do, bring my decimal point straight up, right? Like we've been practicing in the last video. 4 into 27 can go, because I can't go into 2. I have to go into that whole 27. How many times does it go? 4 times 7 is 28, so that's too big. So it must be 4 times 6, which is 24. I have 3 left over. I'm going to bring the 5 down. 4 into 35 goes how many times? Excuse me. 4 times 7 was 28. 4 times 8, 32. I have 3 left over. So at this point, I still have a remainder, right? So I've already got a decimal point up here. I can just start dropping in zeros. So this one, I don't need to add the decimal point, but I can add as many zeros after here as I need to in order to sort of run out of remainder. Okay, 7 into 30. Oh, I said it. 4 into 30 goes 7. I said it wrong. 28, right? 2 left over. I'm going to add in another 0, drop it down. 4 into 20. Ah, look at that. It's going to be 20. I ran out of room again. So up here, I could say that 27 and a half divided by 4 is 6.875, or 6.875 thousandths. Here's another thing that I just want you to sort of realize. I can also, when I have decimals and I'm dividing it with decimals, I can divide a smaller number by a larger number. So you might be looking at this saying, you know, there's no way. 4 can't go into 3. 3 is smaller. But if I use this add a decimal point and a zero technique that we've just been talking about, I can solve this problem. It'll end up as a fractional amount, right? How many times? So all I did, I dropped in my decimal point, brought it up, dropped in a zero. Can 4 go into 30? Absolutely. It goes 7 times, which is 28. That means I have 2 left over. I still have a remainder, so I'm going to drop in a zero and bring it down. 4 into 20 goes 5, which is 20, and now I have no remainder left. So even though 4 is larger than 3, and in you know whole numbers, I shouldn't be able to divide 4 into 3 because the 3 is smaller. If I add in a decimal point and a zero, I can still divide these numbers. So we'll practice this in class, and it'll go well. You guys can totally do this.